Thank you. Good morning, and welcome to our celebration of the Holy Eucharist. We welcome any visitors to our parish. Today is the 25th Sunday in Ordinary Time. In His Gospel, God has called us to possess the glory of our Lord Jesus Christ. We offer today's Mass for the living deceased members of the Burkle family. Please join in singing our entrance hymn, 425, Canticle of the Sun, 425. Thank you.
Thank you. Let us pray. O God, who founded all the commands of your sacred law upon love of you and of our neighbor, grant that by keeping your precepts, we may merit to attain eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and in the hope in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call him while he is near. Let the scoundrel forsake his way, and the wicked his thoughts. Let him turn to the Lord for mercy. To our God, who is generous and forgiving, for my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways, says the Lord. As high as the heavens are above the earth, so high are my ways above your ways, and my thoughts above your thoughts. The word of the Lord. The Lord is near to all who call upon him.
The Lord is near to all who call upon him.
Every day will I bless you, and I will praise your name forever and ever. Great is the Lord, and highly to be praised. His greatness is unsearchable. The Lord is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and of great kindness. The Lord is good to all and compassionate toward all his works. The Lord is just in all his ways and holy in all his works. The Lord is near to all who call upon him, to all who call upon him in truth. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, Christ will be magnified in my body, whether by life or by death. For to me life is Christ, and death is gain. If you go on living in the flesh, that means fruitful labor for me, and I do not know which I shall choose. I am caught between the two. I long to depart this life and be with Christ, for that is far better. Yet that I remain in the flesh is more necessary for your benefit. Only conduct yourselves in a way worthy of the gospel of Christ, the word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you all. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus told his disciples this parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a landowner who went out at dawn to hire laborers for his vineyard. After agreeing with them for the usual daily wage, he sent them into his vineyard. Going out about 9 o'clock, the landowner saw others standing idle in the marketplace, and he said to them, "You too, go into my vineyard, and I will give you what is just." So they went off, and he went out again around noon and around 3 o'clock and did likewise. Going out about 5 o'clock, the landowner found others standing around and said to them, "Why do you stand here idle all the day?" They answered, "Because no one has hired us." He said to them, "You too, go into my vineyard." When it was evening, the owner of the vineyard said to the foreman, "Summon the laborers and give them their pay, beginning with the last and ending with the first." When those who had started about 5 o'clock came, each received the usual daily wage. So when the first came, they thought that they would receive more. But each of them also got the usual wage. And on receiving it, they grumbled against the landowner, saying, "These last ones worked only 1 hour, and you have made them equal to us, who bore the days of burden and all the heat." He said to one of them in reply, "My friend, I am not cheating you. Did you not agree with me for the usual daily wage? Take what is yours and go. What if I wish to give this last one the same as you? Or am I not free to do as I wish with my own money? Are you envious because I am generous? Thus, the last will be the first. The first will be the last." This is the Holy Gospel of the Lord. My dear friends in Jesus Christ, last Sunday we heard that Matthew was reminding us how often we have to forgive to our fellow brethren. But today, the question we see is how much we have to pay our brethren in terms of human relations and needs. In the parable we heard, some were hired early in the morning and others in different times, 5 times, but paid the same living wage equally. In reality, God is infinitely more interested in our own genuine needs than we can possibly imagine. No matter we entered the vineyard the last hour, the last last moment, he catered our all genuine needs according to our genuine needs. He knows each one of us very personally, what we are, where we are, what we need, where we need, and so forth. Some people say it is injustice, and argue about the fairness of that landlord paying the same wage to the last hour workers without considering the day-long hard work of the people started from the first hour. But remember, God's fairness, God's justice is something different than ours or the world. His equitarian justice forces him to give everyone according to their genuine need, but not the equal distribution. At the end of the day, we can be assured that God has kept his word and nobody is left behind from his caring, loving eyes. The one who started the last hour, he may have or she may have family of 4 or 5 children. Their hunger and thirst is same as the one who started the first hour. So that is the meaning of equitarian distribution, not equality. Everybody should be 5 foot or 6 foot. No, that is a short and long. That is, diversity in the unity. So we often look God in the human terms, our perspective. We make him as small-minded as ourselves. But God's ways are different from ours. Means God's generosity is beyond our human standards, our human consideration, but it is an equitarian justice. Sometimes we may think, why should we try or hard or work the whole day, the whole life? If we can gain, we can attain things at the last hour, why should we? Let us enjoy and merry make, the Epicurean philosophy. We will do something the last hour. Let the old people do the rosary, the prayers. Let the young and youth enjoy and merry make. If time get, we try the last hour. If we get the same wage, why should we say? So as we know, the 11th hour people were not lazy people, lazy dozers, avoiding the work, but really wanted to work. But nobody called them or nobody hired them. That is the fact. As you know, in the olden time, even today in our place, the laborers go and stand in the junction, the marketplace, where all the employer come and select the workers for each trade, the carpenter, the mason, the electrician, or whatever they want, they take from the marketplace, the junction, they stand there. If you look this picture of today's gospel, these people waited there. Normally, employers select the cream, the very good one, the young one, good looking, the healthy one, a talented or skilled one. So most probably the 11th hour people, maybe the leftovers, will be normally the rejects, the handicapped old woman, and some kind of handicap, waiting to the call of somebody. Here comes the real meaning of the parable of today. Unless and until somebody preach, somebody teach, how can we hear? How can some teacher or parents taught the children, how can they learn? Unless and until we hear and understand, how can we follow? How can we follow or understand things? So it is not their problem. They are waiting for somebody's beck and call. So according to the Old Testament context, the 11th hour people were considered as sinners and Gentiles, the outcast. Those who had been working all the day long were the Jews, the elected people of God. The vineyard was the kingdom of God. But God was offering the kingdom to the sinners, Gentiles, on equal terms with the Jews, the high caste. No discrimination there. But naturally, Jewish people rejected this idea vigorously because they thought it is unfair, because they expected the preferential treatment. They are the elected people because they had been doing Lord's work all their life. Here the bottom line is the superiority complex of the Jewish vis-a-vis the sinners, Gentiles, but the generosity of God equalized everything. The Jews thought that God worked on the basis of merit system. That is, if you work more, you get more, but if you work little, and you will get little. Here God makes it clear that he does not work on commission system at all, but God is our loving, generous Father who protects the strong and the weak equally and equitably, even to the sinners and Gentiles and the outcast as well. My dear friends, in certain extent, we all are the 11th hour workers. Still, we are getting God's extraordinary goodness and blessing. It is not our worthiness, but out of his mercy and love. Being the sinners and strangers, he died, suffered, and he shed his last drop of blood in order to serve you and me. That is his graciousness, generosity. It is not our merit, but graciousness and generosity of God. So our main concern must not be the rewards and remuneration alone, but the simple joy of serving God. Simple joy by serving God and be grateful. And it is a privilege, so to say, to work all the day from the very beginning, all the day, all through life long in the Lord's vineyard. Not having that jealousy, why the last hour people stolen the same share. That jealous attitude may not work. Even the thief who hanged the right side, by dying point, he was stolen the heaven even, so to say. He asked, When you reach in the paradise, consider me as well. Then Jesus said, today you will be with me in the paradise. Literally, he's stolen the heaven the last hour. He is the 11th hour laborer. So let us reflect a while. Where Jesus said, God's mercy, God's love, God's providence and protection is equally with us, provided we cooperate. Thus, the last will be the first will be the last. Please stand. I believe in one God.
Father, through your Holy Spirit, the disciples remembered all that Jesus taught them. Pour out your Spirit on the church, that she may be faithful to the teaching. We pray to the Lord. Almighty God, we pray for our country and those who protect it. May we as a nation promote justice and peace throughout the world. We pray to the Lord. Light of all nations, look upon those who live in darkness. Open their hearts to accept you as the one true God. We pray to the Lord. We give thanks for the order of created things. You have blessed us with the resources of the earth and the gift of human life. We pray to the Lord. Bless and reward all those who have helped us with their prayers and gifts to restore and maintain our church building and cemetery. We pray to the Lord. We pray for all who are homeless. We pray for families searching for a place to live and for refugees driven from their homeland. We pray to the Lord. Life was your gift to us. May those who have died come to its fullness in you. We pray to the Lord.
Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Please join in singing our offertory hymn, 649, Seek the Lord, 649.
Pray, friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Receive in favor, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what they profess with devotion and faith may be theirs through these heavenly mysteries, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you all. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Father most holy, for fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people. And so with the angels and all the saints, who we declare your glory as with one voice, we acclaim. Sending down your spirit upon them like the dew fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time when he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Donald, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember the departed souls whom we remember in this Eucharist. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her chaste spouse, Saint Wilfrid, our parish patron, who have pleased with you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours for ever and ever. Teaching of the Lord. Let us pray the prayer which Jesus has taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days that, by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, safe from all the distress, all the difficulties, all the tensions of our day-to-day life, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb.
Thank you.
of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, have mercy. Thank you.
Be seated. There is a saying, rather a dictum, part to meet, meet to part. We all come to this world to go. From house of house we go to come back. That is why we say part to meet, meet to part. So finally, I am going to say the farewell. I had been here about 3 years. You were very good to me and you helped me a lot in my priestly ministry and pastoral work. I learned many things and there are very many good souls who helped me, supported me, encouraged me in different ways. You made a important role, memorial mark in my life, so I am grateful. So since the world is very close because of the media, even the internet, the email and WhatsApp or Skype, we can contact, we can pray for each other. If I could make any impact and you could have feel something, I appreciate and request with you, to you, please pray sometimes at least a small prayer for me so that I can continue my ministry in a meaningful way. And I am waiting to go in October middle if things are okay. We started planning from July onwards. It is prolonging. And finally they say the airport, international airport, will open by October. So I am hoping to go by second week or third week of the October. So thank you for all your love and concern. God bless you. We keep each other in our prayers. Please stand for final blessing.
Let us pray. Graciously raise up, O Lord, those you renew with this sacrament, that we may come to possess your redemption both in mystery and in the manner of our life, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you all. May Almighty God bless us, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord and His people.
Thanks be to God.
Fed by the Word of God and the bread of life, let us go forth singing our closing hymn, 582, Companions on the Journey, 582.